Student Involvement invites you to the 3 A's of Awesome with Neil Pasricha as part of its Distinguished Speaker Series at 7:30 p.m. Thursday, January 28th in the Texas Southmost College Arts Center. Admission is free, but seating is limited. Doors open at 7 p.m. for UTRGV students, faculty, and staff with a valid UTRGV ID. For more information, contact the Office of Student Involvement. Car break-ins on the UTRGV campus have students here in Brownsville worried. Coming up, we'll tell you how the UTRGV Police Department is handling this situation and what you can do to prevent a burglary from happening to you.
Hey there, thanks for joining us on this week's edition of UTRGV TV. I am Orlando Vargas. Well, at the top of our broadcast, the parking lots here at UTRGV see a number of students' and faculty's vehicles, but recent break-ins have students concerned. Our reporter, Stephen Cavazos, joins us now from Brownsville. And Stephen, what are the latest developments?
Well, Orly, I'm here on the UTRGV Brownsville campus where 3 vehicles were broken into over the holidays. The break-ins occurred on 2 different parking lots around the campus, one being B2 right behind me. And students here in Brownsville are beginning to feel worried.
Each day, students travel from their homes to attend school here at UTRGV. And Alondra Torres says a student's vehicle is more than just a means of transportation.
We're always traveling as students, and we kind of sometimes practically live in our cars.
The UTRGV Police Department sent this email indicating 3 vehicles were broken into over the holidays, and Torres is feeling nervous.
Kind of scary to hear that there's break-ins and that it can be anyone's car, really.
According to police reports, 2 motor vehicles and 1 university vehicle were broken into on January 16th and January 17th during the early morning hours.
The first one that occurred on Friday night, or it was between 9:45 p.m. and about 1:30 a.m. And then the subsequent evening on Saturday night, our patrol officers that were patrolling the parking lots discovered 2 other vehicles that had been burglarized.
In order to ensure the safety of your items and vehicle, 3 tips may help in lowering your chances of a break-in.
Always make sure you park your cars in well-surrounded areas. And make sure any valuable items are not left in your vehicle. And of course, make sure your vehicle is locked.
For now, Chief Munguia and the UTRGV Police Department want to ensure students and faculty that they will continue to patrol the surrounding areas.
We are spread out. And given the fact, you know, that we do have a large area that we're responsible for, is that we depend on the community, if they see anything suspicious, you know, to not hesitate to give us a call, you know, because we will send officers out there immediately to go investigate.
As of now, no suspect has been identified, but the UTRGV PD does not believe these vehicle break-ins are connected, but they do urge students to stay cautious of their surroundings. For now in Brownsville, Stephen Cavazos, UTRGV TV.
Well, 2 neighboring cities are at odds with each other over hosting the 40th anniversary of Border Fest. The cities of Hidalgo and McAllen have sent cease and desist letters to each other. Judge Aida Salinas signed a temporary restraining order against the city of McAllen this past Tuesday. An injunction hearing is scheduled for February 2nd, and plans to organize the event have stopped, and McAllen has the rights to use the title of Border Fest. 2016 is an important year for politics, and we wanted to know if students know who's left in the race, as well as why they support certain candidates. Here's Patty Hinojosa with this week's Man on the Street.
It's a new year here at UTRGV, and while some students are worried about finding their classes or looking for parking, I want to figure out why Donald Trump might be America's next president.
So we got Hillary Clinton, Bernie, is that dude?
Trump, Clinton, Sanders, Cruz.
The Republicans we have among so many, Donald Trump, of course, Ted Cruz, Marco Rubio, Ben Carson, Jeb Bush, Kasich, Rand Paul, I think so, yeah.
Wow, that's the most that somebody has been able to name out of all the Republicans.
Bernie Sanders, Hillary Clinton, Jeb Bush, Donald Trump.
I know we have Trump and Sarah Palin. I think she's supporting Trump. I don't know if she's running. I don't think she's running.
I can tell you this. I'm voting for Donald Trump this year.
I don't like Trump. I think he's sexist. I think he's fascist. I think everything that he's saying right now is just ridiculous, and I don't really support him.
The difference between being like politically correct and being like having an opinion is there is actually a really big difference.
I wish people would not vote for Donald Trump, but the ignorance of America and people not knowing who this man is, they're going to vote for him because there is so much propaganda for this man and he has not spent a single cent and he might actually win. I hate to say that.
I really like Bernie just because I like his policy. I like that he never really changed over the course of his career because Clinton has flip-flopped on a lot of issues.
So you're feeling the burn?
I'm feeling the burn for sure.
So would you say you're feeling the burn?
Right now? Or? Yeah, I am.
Can you tell me why?
Because I'm put on spot and...
Oh, feeling the burn is actually a term that Bernie Sanders... You said you supported Bernie Sanders.
Oh!
Bernie Sanders supporters. It's a hashtag they use out there.
I think right now he's got all of the youth supporting him, all of the college students, and I think they're all going to maybe vote for him. Maybe that will be his outcome.
Who do you think would win in a fight between Donald Trump and Hillary Clinton?
In a campaign or in a fight?
In a boxing fight, physically.
Boxing fight, I think Donald Trump would win.
Well, after interviewing the UTRGV student body, I have to say I'm pretty scared. Reporting for UTRGV TV, I am Patty Nahosa.
Opportunity, defined as a moment for action, a chance to do something, change everything. Opportunity is what drove freshman guard Antonio Green from his hometown of Tupelo, Mississippi, all the way down south to UTRGV.
I knew coming in that I have the opportunity to contribute right away. I mean, I didn't know to be this much, but I mean, I knew I have the opportunity to do that. I mean, I didn't want to go nowhere, I wasn't going to play it, so I just felt like it was a good thing for me.
Opportunity for Antonio arrived quickly. During the Vaqueros' first road trip of the year in Florida, Green was tabbed as the lone freshman starter along three seniors.
I think Coach Watson was the first person to tell me I was going to start. I mean, it was pretty exciting news to hear, you know, that I was going to start as a freshman. But I mean, it's nothing, like I wasn't surprised or nothing, you know, nothing like that. But I was happy about it. Yeah, I told my mama. Yeah, I mean, she was there in Miami, but I, like they went home the next day and I think I like texted her and told her I'd be starting in the next game.
Immediately, Green made an impact, scoring in double digits on the road against Houston, North Florida, and Utah State. That type of instant confidence from a first-year player didn't surprise UTRGV assistant coach Willie Watson.
One of the words that I would say to describe him, just from all the research I had done on him, and then the game I actually watched him play in, was he was a gamer. And what I mean by that was, when the lights was on and, you know, the crowd was, it was a big rivalry game, one of the games I went to, and you just see just the excitement he had, just, you know, he had an extra bounce to his step, and you knew, and when you see a guy like that, you just know those type of guys that up for games and love to compete, and that's one of the things I would say about Antonio, he don't back down from a challenge, and when it's time to compete, He really steps his game up.
What Antonio Green brings to the table for the Vaqueros on the court is a diverse skill set, most notably a three-point shot that has dropped in over 45% of the time.
And I feel like shooting is one of the things I do best, but I mean, I feel like I'm a good passer. I can rebound. I feel like I can do a little bit of everything pretty well. I mean, I try to take what the defender give me, and the coach always stresses about getting the ball inside, so I try to do that too at the same time. But I mean, I usually decide what I'm gonna do off the defender though.
Being a sharp shooter allows Green to create space for the team's offense and open up opportunities for his teammates.
What we try to do with our motion offense, you know, shooting is important. Shooting is important, and I think he's adapted well, and he really fit that piece in terms of being able to shoot the ball. And passing, but he's pretty skilled overall, you know, in terms of handling the ball, shooting the ball, making good decisions. You know, as a point guard, as a guard in general, you know, you have to have a good mind for the game, and I think he got a pretty good feel for that.
Green's ability to lead all freshmen across the nation in three-point percentage springs from a mature attitude that is rare in a first-year player.
I think staying level is probably one of my stronger things. I mean, don't too many things get to me. The crowd, what the coach saying, I mean, what people say. I mean, when I'm playing, that's what I focus on. I focus on playing. I think a lot of people can't do that, and I think that's a big advantage for me, especially being a freshman.
that maturity can be connected to the key part Green's family plays in his life.
My family, my mom and my daughter. I mean, I know my mom, she done so much for me. She real supportive. I mean, she always support me. Whatever I want to do, she never makes me do anything. It's always whatever I decide to do, and she just supports me.
You know, getting to know his mom throughout this process, and you see where it stems from. Like I say, he still got a lot of growing to do in a lot of areas, but I think just his humble nature and his willingness to compete and get better every day. And I think anytime you got that, you got a chance to obviously be something special.
As Antonio Green continues to take advantage of the opportunity and rewards the coaches that gave it to him, it's his nearly two-year-old daughter that puts into perspective what he can do with this moment.
I just try to keep in mind that, the main reason I'm here is for her getting an education, trying to better myself. So, I mean, I just try to always remember why I'm down here and why every day I'm practicing, why every day I'm going to class. It's for her. I mean, it's a long way from home, not being able to see her every day, but I mean, it's for her. So, I mean, it's easy to kind of get through the process and use her as motivation.
And for Antonio, he expects to take advantage of every chance to widen his future, to play the sport, and be with the people he loves.
I really believe that I have a good chance to possibly play basketball professionally for money one day. I just want to do that to take care of my family. You know, I mean, I don't want to be in Tupelo for the rest of my life, so hopefully I get a nice home somewhere.
And to watch stories like the one that you just saw, go ahead and log on to YouTube.com. Search for Go UTRGV Athletics. And joining us now is our sports director, Daniel Galvan. And Daniel, what is happening around V Nation in sports?
A lot of great things, Orly. The two basketball teams have, I think, waited for the students here at UTRGV to come by for the spring semester, and they've started off very strong. And I'll get you guys covered with this week's sports segment. But before I get into the highlights, I first have to ask you for two things. One, $20, or at least a Whataburger gift card. Seriously, that'd be great. But more importantly, number two, to come out to the UTRGV Fieldhouse Saturday night at 7 o'clock to watch our women's basketball team play Seattle University. The team, our team, has had a phenomenal start to the conference schedule. They're 5-0, undefeated. Come by the Fieldhouse, enjoy the band, watch the dancers and the cheerleaders, and catch the team. They are great. And last week on the road, the women's basketball team beat Chicago State 64-56 with forward Anushka Maldonado putting up 28 points. That's one for every Republican presidential candidate. And then last Saturday in Missouri, the squad won 62-53 thanks to a combined 34 points from team leader Shantae Goff and Raquel Preston. That's one point for every second Martin O'Malley would like to speak. Next week, I'll have the highlights from the ladies' Thursday-Saturday homestand, but right now I have highlights from last week's UTRGV men's basketball victory over Chicago State. UTRGV beat Chicago State 82-72, and there were five vaqueros in double digits. So I'm going to show highlights from all five of those performances. First, Antonio Green, who leads all freshmen in the nation in three-point percentage. He was on fire like Katniss Everdeen. He hit some buckets, making five of his 9 three-point attempts, and he scored 21 points to go with 6 assists and 5 rebounds. There's a celebrity in the house up front is star writer, sports reporter Nate Matta. Now on to J.J. Thompson, our stud. He was great on defense, but he also made an impact on offense with 18 points, 8 assists, and he shot 50% from the field. Random backflip onto the big men. Shaq Hines was an angel, one angel that is very good at hoops. Shaq had a double-double with 10 points to go with 14 rebounds. And Dan Camasa, who our offense runs through at times, scored 16 and he had 7 boards while protecting the paint with 4 blocks. Here's Coach Hipsher telling Dan Camasa that Stephen Avery is totally innocent. And then Sergeant Dakota Slaughter made his defenders look meek, going back to back with shots. He started from the bottom, but he went from 0 to 100 to take care of Marvin's room. That's the motto. Dakota had 17 points, 5 rebounds, and 1 lost shoe. Here's him putting his footwear back on. That's cool. Then on Saturday, the team took care of business and defended home court with a 71-66 win over the UMKC Kangaroos. It was a hard-fought hop-in battle as both Dakota Slaughter and J.J. Thompson fouled out in the game, but the team still won. There were 42 fouls called in that game, lots of whistles, and it was a great week for UTRGV. Both teams went 4-0. They are both undefeated here at home in conference play, and that's it for me. I'll be back next week with the latest in UTRGV sports with women's basketball defending home court. Back to you, Orlando.
Well, thank you, Daniel, for that sports recap, and that's all we have for you today. We want to remind you that if you have a story you'd like for us to know about, you can find us on Facebook. Just search for UTRGVTV, or you can email us at utrgvtv@gmail.com. And if you have a Twitter account, don't forget to tweet us. You can also find us at UTRGVTV. And I want to thank you again for tuning in to our newscast. I'm Orlando Vargas. See you until next time.